Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude. You have been warned. Hey guys, welcome to Gaming Theater. I'm your host, James, aka Wade D. McGinnis. And tonight we'll be taking a look at Craven Manor from Demon Wagon Studios. You can get it on Steam for $9.99, or you can go to IndieDB and get it for free. Now, the difference between the two is one, when you buy it, you are supporting the developers. Two, you are getting additional content. Yes, there is a free demo out there circulating, and it is the actual entirety of the game, as far as I can tell. The game is kind of short. You guys know that I have been out playing on this. I had an original gaming theater from last year. I did a Indie Wednesday on this. I've done quite a bit of late night horror. I've done quite a bit of content for Craven Manor as a whole. And this is the full release. Let's just jump into it. Let's go Nightmare this time. The difference between one and the other is that, obviously, one's just harder. Now, this game actually has a lot of good scares. It's got a lot of good mechanics. I think my only gripe with this game is that there's not a whole lot of story that's fleshed out. I feel like there should be more story to it. I also feel like the developers should have spent more time with this idea of adjusting the levels, the layout of the game. And tweaking that around and just expanding on it. It's a good first rough draft, but I feel like they could have done far more had they expanded on it. This machinery is looking for a missing lever. Aha. See, I know where to go. I played the game. Love how there's a baddie. There's a battery icon in the upper right-hand corner. Do I actually have a flashlight? Well, I almost knew where to go. I'm pretty sure I knew where to go. I know where to go. That's one of those things where you played the game, you can't exactly get to him. I'm already aware of the situation of the horrors and the scares, because it's all the same. Once you play through this game once, admittedly, you'll basically know the entire thing. It doesn't mean that it's not any scary, and that it's definitely not bone-chilling. This game definitely hits the right notes. Natalie, the right notes. Alright. Pick the key up here. No, I don't want that. No. What it wants is the handyman. This is missing an important piece. I would really love to get in that room. I've never been in that room. This bronze aperture looks like it could house a round of objects. Threatening sending memo from Wayne Craven addressed to a contractor. Subject structures must be built exactly to specifications. Ancient books, Nethermancian lentils, and alchemy. Why not? Let's try to bypass mortality by becoming bronze statues, or, you know, statues of some kind. Oh, that's right, he's still a statue. He's usually right there. You turn around and he moves, which should give you the indication to leave! Leave! A storm would not be that bad. I have been in some seriously bad storms in my life. I'm cycling through my commands, and I... Actually, it is a flashlight. And squeak goes the bird. He's like, I'm gonna throw this on you. Immediately also have the volume slightly lower. To E. What the fuck? What? What? No way. I apparently just got a... Wait. Get out! I just got a follower. I did not know I had Twitch alert on. And ended up actually getting a follower. So we're gonna walk down here. Because, you know, that's a budging bad idea. Okay, get out. Oh, it's an old mechanical flashlight. The ones where you, like, wound up and... Ah! Hey, buddy! Oh my god! Turn the light on! Okay, is he still down here? No? Apparently that motherfucker actually moves, so that's the mechanics of I said that I had the volume lower, and I said that was for your safety, and I meant that, but apparently I'm still a chicken. Who knew? I let the flashlight actually get up there. Oh my god, College Man 1, if you ever happen to see this gaming theater episode, know that you're welcome to the stream anytime, and that you scare the hell out of me. Oh, I didn't. I gotta turn that off. That's what I'm doing. Am I any video recording I do from here on out that's local? That gets shut off. Thank you, OBS, for doing that to me. You're lovely. Love you. Not really, but you know. It's a pretend love. Can I. No? No? Alright. It's a fabricated love of. Something. Okay. Alright. Shuts the door on me. Why not? Because he's a dick. Actually, the enemy might be a woman. That might also be a man. In this case, both genitals have been removed for the safety of the bronze statuing. Because nobody would not want that freaking. Nobody would want that bronzed. Alright, let's. Ooh, good. Good. Yeah, that moves. I'm not gonna. There we go. See, it screws with. Gets in your mind. This game actually does a good job of doing that. Alright, so look at this. Little statue. Sucker statue. That's what you do. Sucker statue. And I hate you for it. Okay. Na 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 na. Hi! Blue skies, nothing but blue skies. From now, that's a bloody screen. Alright, that is a bloody screen. And... I absolutely feel... Woo! Woo! Ha! Felt like I played this before? Of course I've played this before. This is going to save me. Ounces and ounces of ladder control. Got my goodies! That's Bale! Bale! Love to find a computer though. And as you can see, the game's atmosphere, the artistic style, direction, does remind me of Amnesia, but it does have a very unique twist. This idea of switching the rooms around and altering the layout, if they improve upon this, it's gonna go far with them. And it's actually, in my opinion, gonna be really, really good. I hope that they get enough funding to allow for a sequel, or at least an iteration. And a better version of this. Watch that, that's just gonna move. I think. Yeah, see, look at that! I knew that! Just, the things you know, the horror that you learned to deal with. Literally. at a speed running this, but that's okay. So many doors that are locked. Some doors that connect to one another. Oh, shit. Okay. It's a regular mode. I had this phobia that it was gonna kind of get me as I come up this, but it's an unsettling phobia is what it is. There's a weird little jump shop game in here, by the way. It's very strange. It's very strange. It's... Hey! Shit. Or not. No, we. That's fabricated. Blah blah blah. How'd you get by in there, buddy? Silly boy. So I gotta go grab the ball. There we go. Nice. Throw an object. And kushu! This is why I never made it in the basketball league. Is it a league? I don't know if it's a league. It's probably. I don't watch that much sports. I watch esports. That's what I. And even then, that's sparingly. Oh, wait, nope, that went in. Yes. So I don't have anything in sports. I play sports. I just don't watch sports. Sorry, when I play horror games, I admittedly, even if I've already played them, it still puts me in tension. Duh! That was not cool. That actually did exist, though. That was cool. Can I grab that? That's. That's the gear that. Why? Oh. Alright, so the window is broken over there, I guess. Maybe I can grab something and throw it? Sounds like it's stirring me. Okay. Pick that up? Nope. Did you have one of those little container things? Those little mini jugs? What about this? Look at this, sir. We went broke. See if we can't dislodge it. Okay, no. Oh god, that's. It's trying to hurt me. Okay! Now, push! So we know where the gear is, which is good. Was I supposed to get something there? Other than just being able to see the gear. I feel like I'm missing a very valuable piece. Like that piece. That would be the valuable piece that I was missing. Alright. Oh! Alright, did I drop? See, I did. Uh-oh. Fudge! We're gonna shut that door. We're gonna leave that door behind. We're not going back in that room. Thank you, good sir. You have been wonderful. Alright, I need this. Okay. Oh dear. I feel my heart slightly in my throat, which is lovely. That's always good. It's always a great feeling. Oh. Listen. No. Now see, that's actually a really good mechanic, and here is why. If we go in here, guess what? Who's back? Say, look at these. The ninja. Hi, buddy! first I was afraid. I was petrified. I think I can't play this game anymore, guys. Where are you coming? Oh my god, he's so... We are so... Uh-oh. Yep, hi buddy. Oh, I don't like the fact that I can see you when you move. Okay, that's it. This has been Craven Manor. I have been your host, James, aka Wade DeMiguel. This has been Gaming Theater. You can get the game right now for $9.99. Of course, with it being Halloween, or the end of October, beginning of November. Perfect time to give to a loved one and scare the living shit out of them. Like I said, if you aren't too sure, you can always try out the demo or the semi-full game on EBDB for free. And then if you really want it, you can go and get it on Steam for $9.99 or your regional equivalent. So as always, guys, catch you next time.
Hey guys, make sure you check out the videos below for more happy fun times. And if you already haven't, hit that subscriber button to let you know when more happy moments are coming to you on my channel. And finally, if you haven't, hit the like button. Gives you chocolate. No, I'm actually lying. Which I could give you chocolate. Chocolate.